So in the last episode, we were able to fetch data from our backend API using create async thunk. And in this episode, I want us to do the same using RTK query. And RTK query is now considered as an advanced way of fetching data from an API in Redux Toolkit. So to get started, you need to have your backend running. And then inside our features folder, we'll add a new file called productsapi.js. So right here, I'll say productsapi.js. And what we'll do in this file, we'll simply register an API service to fetch data from our backend API. So at the top here, we'll import two things, that is create API and fetch this query from Redux Toolkit query. So right here, I'll say import, I'll destructure create API, and also I'll destructure fetch base query, and these will be coming from at Redux Toolkit stroke query and then stroke react. And now we can be able to use this create API to create an API service. So right here, I'll export const products API and I'll set this to be equal to create API. I invoke this and right here I'll pass an object, and in here we'll have three things. The first one will be reducer path, and I'll set the reducer path to be products API. Right here we are simply giving our API service a name. And then the second thing, we will set up our base URL. So right here we have base query, and how we set up our base URL, we will use fetch base query. So right here I'll say fetch base query, and then I invoke this, I pass an object, and we'll set the base URL to be whatever we have here. So our base URL will be HTTP localhost 5000. So this is the base URL. I will copy this. And this is supposed to be only be products without double S, only one S. So if you'll be using create async thunk, please make sure you have the correct endpoint right there. Now I'll come to this other file, and I'll include the quotes and pass HTTP localhost 5000 as our base URL. And then the third thing we'll have right here is endpoints, and we can be able to set different endpoints of which will have access to our base URL. So right here I'll use a function which is an arrow function, and right here we'll have access to an object called builder. And right here we can register an endpoint. I'll call this one get all products, and then we'll make use of our builder to access the query method. So I'll say builder.query and I'll invoke this. And now in here I can say query, I use a full colon, I pass in an arrow function, and right here I'll pass the endpoint. So our endpoint will be products, just like that. Okay, now what will happen is that these products will be magically be added to our base URL. So at the end of the day, we'll be making a request to HTTP localhost 5000 stroke products. Okay, and then this get all products will be used to create a custom hook automatically, and we can be able to export that hook like this. I can say export const. So right here we'll be able to destructure our hook from products API. So right here I can have products API, and now right here if I try to say use, you'll see we have a cool suggestion. You will see we have use get all products query. So if I click this, you'll see this custom hook was automatically created from get all products. And what was added is use and query at the end. And we can be able to use this custom hook to now call our API service from our components, which is really cool, okay? And another thing that we will need to do now is to include our product API reducer in our store. So what I will do, I'll go into index.js file. And from this file, we will import our product API. So right here, I'll say import. I will destructure product API right here from features product API. And now I can use this product API to access the name of our API service. I'll access this reducer path, and also I'll be able to access the reducer itself. So right here we'll add our product API reducer, and we'll do it like this. We'll use square brackets to access the reducer path. So I'll say product API, and then I'll say dot reducer path. And this will get the name of our reducer path right here. It will simply get our product API. So that is what we'll have there. And we will set this to be product API. And then we say dot reducer. And then one more thing that we can do is to configure a custom middleware. And how you can configure custom middleware is that inside this object, we have this reducer as our first property, and we can have another property right here called middleware. So I'll say middleware, and I'll set this to be an arrow function, which will have access to get default middleware. And then this can be an arrow function, and we can make use of this get default middleware to add our products API, a custom middleware. So this is how you can do it. We'll say get default middleware. We call this, and I'll call a method right here, dot concat. And then I'll pass in our products API dot middleware. Just like that. So we are supposed to remove this. I don't know why this was added, so if yours was added, please make sure you get rid of that. And let me just give you a very quick overview of what we have done so far. We are creating a new API service which will help us to fetch data from our backend API. And to do that, we are importing two things from Redux Toolkit query, and that is create API and fetch a base query. Now, we use create API to create our product API, and this create API is accepting the properties. We have the reducer path, and now you can see we are accessing this reducer path and using it to add our reducer at our store right here. And then we have a base query, and at base query is where we are adding a base URL. Now, with the help of fetch base query, we are being able to add a base URL. And then right here we can register endpoints, and our first endpoint right here is get all products. So you can have multiple right here if they are accessing the same base URL. So maybe you can have get product by ID and so on, but right here we are getting all the products, and we have access to builder.query. And then right here we are making a query to products. And magically, these products will be added to our base URL. So we'll be basically making a query to HTTP localhost 5000 stroke products. Okay. And now this get all products will automatically be used to generate a custom hook, use get all products query, and we can export it like this. And we'll now be able to make use of this hook to call our API service right here. Okay. And now in our index.js, we are adding our product API reducer to the state, and we are also adding a custom middleware from product API.middleware, and this will add more functionality to our API service, such as caching, and we have more. So I leave a link at the description section below to the documentation so that you can read more. Now, the next step that remains is to call our hook and be able to fetch the data from our product API service. So how we can call the hook is to come to home right here, which is our component, and just at the top of the return, we can be able to say use get all products query. I'll just call like that and it will be auto imported. And then right here, I can invoke it. And whatever we'll get from this particular call is our data. So right here, I can say const, and we'll be able to destructure our data from this particular call. Now, the cool thing is that we not only get the data, but we'll also have access to error and is loading. And we can now be able to use those to either display an error if in case there is an error, or display a spinner in case we are still fetching the data. Okay, so right here we will also have access to the error, and we'll also have access to is loading, which is really nice. And with this, we now don't need to do something like this. We don't need to manually determine the state of our status. This will now happen automatically when using RTK query. So we need to test this one out. I'll just go to my application here and I will refresh just to make sure that everything is refreshed. We are getting an error when using a middleware builder function, an array of middleware must be returned. So I'll come back to index.js file, and actually we are not returning anything, so we need to add a return keyword right here. So we need to include return, and if you don't want to include the return keyword, you can make this one shorter like this. You can remove the brackets, remove the return keyword, and return everything directly just like this. So this should still work, where we are directly returning our middleware without those brackets. So let me now come back and refresh. Now I'll go to our Redux DevTools, and now you can see at our div we have our products API, we have the queries, and our query here is get all products. And when I expand this, you can see the status here is changed from pending to fulfilled. We have the data, and also we have a timestamp. So this is really cool because we are now being able to like get our data. And if I come to state, you can see we have our products API right here, and this is the name we added at our user path. So if I expand this, we have the queries, and for the queries we have get all products. And you can see right here we have undefined because we are not passing any arguments to our call or our use state, so this is undefined. And now we have the status, we have the endpoint, so this is actually working, and we have the data right here. So if I come to actions, this is the action type right here, and this is cool. We are actually getting our data from our backend API. So if you want to get a single product, you can do something like this. At our home, you can be able to pass an argument right here, maybe an ID, and you'll be able to receive that argument in our product API right here. So you'll be able to receive the ID, and then right here you can be able to use template literals to like merge product stroke ID right there, and then this will be automatically be added to our base URL, and then you'll be able to get a single product. So you can be able to do that, but in this case we want to get all our products, so we can ignore that. So this is how you can fetch data using RTK query, and I think it's a bit simplified. When you get used to this syntax, it is actually really cool, and you'll be able to have custom hooks which you can call them directly like this. And now you'll have your data in here, you'll have the error in case of an error, and you'll have is loading to display a spinner. And now in the next episode, we will map through this data and list our products on our UI. So I hope this video was helpful, and if you are not yet subscribed to the channel, please support me, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.